Welcome back to the Middle-earth Shadow of War Gravewalker difficulty walkthrough. We'll go through all of the side quests that we have available to us now, the Slaughter and Outlaw Tribe missions, Shadows of the Past missions, etc. And then we'll do the preparation for Shadow Wars, and we'll go and upgrade all of our keeps and everything, so we're ready for the invasions. And we'll see how much we can fit in, maybe do some of the Shadow War missions as well. Let's get to it. We'll start out with a quick tip on how to quickly level up the Ring Wraith armor set. As you can see, we need to resurrect orcs at a certain level. The quickest way to do this is to kill off your followers. So I'll find two followers that I need to kill, of the types that I need to kill. So I have a Slayer, for example. And a Tank. And then I'll send them into a pit fight battle against each other. Whichever one dies, then I will resurrect that one and should level up that piece of to unlock the ability to resurrect champions, you need to beat the champion fight pit in Minas Mortal. So we'll try and do that now.
I'll provide all the support you need, and then some. You better be a real fighter, and not a brainless gag.
You will be butchered!
Good, and we need to equip the skill now. As you can see, the servant's armor can be upgraded now. And we can do that for all of the pieces. I'm not going to use the Ring Wraith set in my final build, so I'm not going to do the rest of them right now. I just wanted to show you guys a little tip to make it a little bit easier to level up all of these pieces. So basically you can just have your captains fight each other, make sure that they're appropriate level, and then resurrect them after they've died. Next up on our list of things to do to prepare for Shadow Wars is to grab all of the Bright Cord armor set items. So we'll run around each of the maps and grab the pieces. Because we've grabbed all of the Ithildin pieces, we should be able to just unlock each of the doors.
They stalk and lurk, then lash out so furious. Yet our bulwark is proof against their rage. Our hard-ringed, hand-forged armor impervious to predations from the powers of darkness, no matter how vicious or how vile. To assail the Bright Lord is to falter and fail.
Well, on the bright side, the Bright Lord items we get at level 60, which is max, so we won't need to upgrade them now, which is good. Unfortunately, we didn't get any bonus levels for having gotten them with ourselves at level 60, so I guess it helps a bit to have waited this long, but I had hoped we'd get some extra levels. Either way, I'll take it.
Fair Mordor slumbers, entangled in night. A viper's nest of sorrow and strife, poisoned by pernicious betrayal and blight. Trapped in the grasp of gelid corpse hands. Yet behold, the Bright Lord comes as a wildfire, burning only what is base, that all else may thrive.
Let our foes fortify with iron and stone. Let them summon scabrous serpents, feral beasts. It will avail them naught. Across the ages, none have an army that wields such weapons, such woe, such doom against the dark benighted hordes who dare claim dominion over a Mordor soon bright. sun rises, the shadows must retreat, fleeing in fear from the fires of war. The night never knew that its end was fleet, as a bright lord bears beacons of flame. The sun rises, yes, but from the west it shines, marching air eastward, air eternal. In the land of Mordor, where the shadows lie, we bear our banners aloft, boots like drums, our gates quick, our countenance dire. For who in this dark, dream-haunted land dares resist the righteous flame of wrath and doom themselves to despair and death?
Pieces of the Bright Lord armor set. In order to get the sixth piece, we need to do the Shadows of the Past questline, which we'll do next.
Wraith, we had ambition in abundance. I had the One Ring and Sauron did not. He would not dare stand against me. Yet he did.
Outlaw is not too bad, you just have to kill the enemy captain in time without alerting anybody else.
Glory, Outlaw. In those days our triumphs on the battlefield were many. Mordor was ours to claim.
upgrade that I think is the hardest of the Celebrimbor war quests. You have to Shadow Strike kill all of the archers within the time limit and kill all of them from Bird of Prey. So it's a little bit challenging, but you'll see there's a path that you can follow in order to do it.
My dad, the virtue of invention. In life, I had no equal among elven jewelsmiths and artists. If I could conceive it, I could bring it into being. When I went to war against Sauron, I wanted a way to keep my war chiefs in line. Enter the Fear Eater. Even my boldest war chiefs shuddered in his presence.
Come on!
sense of fear is in the air. I think someone out there thinks he's scary. Nightmares, eh? Well, I've seen horrors beyond your petty bad dreams. I consume lesser fears, and I become fear itself! For giving me a hassle! Master!
Profidat is not too bad. You just have to kill 10 orcs, 4 of which you'll have to do Caragor kills from above in stealth without getting detected. So just be a little bit careful, more so than at lower difficulties, because your stealth detection radius is a bit tighter in Gravewalker.
Afadad, the virtue of obedience. Then, as now, raising an army in Mordor meant overwhelming the orcs with a display of power. That power was the one.
Abgen is a timed quest. You'll need to kill all of the orcs and the captain within the allotted time.
Perhaps the highest of virtues is Abgen, foresight. When I made 3 rings for the elves, I had the foresight to ensure that they would not be corrupted like men and dwarves.
Thank you.
Cadenas is not too difficult. You just have to kill 7 orcs within the time limit using Bird of Prey and a few headshots.
Cadenas is our word for bravery. And indeed, it took bravery to march on Mordor and wrest control of it from Sauron himself. When I made war on Sauron, many war chiefs flocked to my banner. Among the most useful, though not the most subtle, was the Gravewalker. He was a terror in battle, and child's play to manipulate.
I'm gonna stomp you into the mud. Then, I'm gonna stomp on you some more. And then, I'll have myself a drink.
I'm not waiting any longer.
No!
Need to get Elf Shot back, and then I'm gonna separate the captains and kill them.
Dark Lord will break your soul.
Sadras. Here in Mordor, loyalty passes from Orc to Captain to Overlord, and the chain of loyalty ends in a ring of power. Thank you. alas, elves are the embodiment of grace. Yet we were taken with this beautiful visitor bearing gifts. In the Second Age, we honored Cirith, the virtue of vigilance. We watched our enemies closely, only to be deceived by Sauron in the guise of a friend. Thank you. One of my ancient war chiefs, the Iron Mount, understood Karagors on an instinctive level. In truth, he was more bestial even than the other Uruks. And every beast can do work, if given the right harness.
Mordor's finest Karagors, bred and trained for hunting and war. Whoever set those Karagors free will surely be their next meal. I've taught my Karagors much, but I've also learned from them. Learned that the only way to slake my bloodlust is to tear flesh from bone!
Thank you.
Megras, an elven virtue celebrated by the jewelsmiths I taught during the Second Age. Kuru, as my army fought its way across Mordor, I sensed my instincts for battle sharpening. Hanas, discernment. When I labored with the Bringer of Gifts to forge the Rings of Power, even Galadriel did not discern how the rings would reshape the world. Champion regarded warfare as an art form, and himself as Mordor's greatest artist. Making him my warchief meant pricking his overweening pride.
Oh,
Someone wants a shot at the title, I see. This is garden variety carnage. Mediocre. Sharpen your blade, intruder. Then test yourself against Mordor's champion!
Serve you. No one will touch you. Fancy yourself a true warrior, do you? You may be flashy with a blade, but I'm not so easily impressed. Your technique has flaws, and I'm about to show them to you.
Ha ha!
Chosen master. Chosen master.
No craftsman succeeds on the first attempt, and it takes an iron will to persevere and prevail. Invade Mordor. Phylas, the virtue of justice. Sauron had betrayed me and my people, and I was determined to punish him for it. Tell us. The orcs respect strength, whether it comes from a Graug, a war chief, or a ring. Yet in Mordor, possessing strength also makes one a tempting target. Most orcs are dullards, but the tricky had cleverness to spare. When we marched against Sauron, a war chief with such cunning was a most useful weapon indeed.
Come on then, mysterious intruder! Stop! step out of the shadows!
Look at that!
He employed cleverness. Occasionally to my shame. Often to my benefit, and in the end, he was as easy to manipulate as any other orc.
Next up, I'm going to do all of the Slaughter Tribe and Outlaw Tribe side quests in each of the regions. I'll start with Borgoroth. And basically, there are two types of missions, one where you face one captain and another where the respective tribe is invading your region, so you'll have a lot of orcs both from the tribe and then orcs that are already in the region opposing them, and you'll need to take out all of the orcs. Not too much commentary for any of these missions. We'll just go through, finish them off using the exploiting the enemy captain weaknesses. And for the ones where we're facing multiple orcs, we'll kind of hang back and let the orcs kill each other off and then pick off the survivors. But I won't comment on each of these quests, we'll just go through each of them and maybe I'll just do the highlights.
Why can't you soft skins accept that Uruks are your betters? You just have to do things the hard way!
Ugh.
What's the matter, Tark? Your fancy cloak and fancy blade, no good against a full-blooded Uruk. Why are you betraying us? Why are all your boys doing the same? Stupid globs! Look at your orbs! Don't you see the fear on their faces? They know what's coming, and it's coming right now! Hey! I'm your chosen! Swine! Uruks will slit your throat every time! And then we start in on the really fun stuff. Your life is ending, Tark. But for all men, the troubles are just beginning. Take us down. We smash menfolk. We rule Mordor. Just like all the works of men in Mordor, you are ruined! This is not how it's supposed to be! Next time you will be mine!
Guess that's it for him!
It seems the city of men is back in your hands. But are you still a man? That is a question.
We will kill every man in Mordor. And then they'll start killing them everywhere else! Surrounded!
Pretty, but we're pretty good at standing while pigskins are lying down.
Scream for me!
You'll pay for this. I'll kill you next time, you filth!
We are... You're all betraying!
last to the last orc, and we will slaughter you to the last orc.
That's right, snarl at me. Maybe I won't notice that you soiled your bitches. Dismembering you afterwards. What will I do with all the pieces?
You're all words. I'm all murderous rage.
Started raising the dead. Tell me, what do their insides smell like after you raise them? Wait, don't tell me. I'll just kill you and take a sniff myself.
You bleed a lot, Pinkskin. Just the way we like.
Pain. I can't wait. It's pathetic the way you wage on. And I've got a surprise that'll shut you up for good.
Gutted and cleaned out within the hour, Ranger.
I have devised a special torture just for you. But first, we will slaughter your whole army.
So you think you can hold back all of Mordor now? That's idiotic, even for a pinkskin.
When you see me, it's already too late. And you see me now.
Ah! have devised a special torture just for you. But first, we will slaughter your whole army.
That's right, snarl at me. Maybe I won't notice that you soiled your britches.
I'm gonna hit you so hard, you'll be shracken teeth for a week! Took Minas Morgul, did you? Now don't go changing the name back. I just got used to the new one.
Body. We're gonna hang you on a hook, Pinkskin, and then we'll beat on your corpse until the meat is nice and tender.
You fight no better than a Gondorian recruit. Wonder how your taste compares. We will suffer no trespassers in Mordor. No man, no elf. No, it is you intruders who will suffer. So much pain, I can't wait! Let's start the show!
Now finished with all of the outlaw and slaughter missions. That is all of them. So we'll go to Cirith, Ungol, and start preparing for the first of the Shadow War missions. For the Shadow War missions, you're going to be defending your keeps. Unless you lose, in which case you'll have to retake them. And it is an ongoing sequence of sieges. So it starts in Cirith, Ungol, and then it'll go to each of the other regions. Then you'll have two regions to defend, then three, then all four. So it's a lot of sieges to defend against. In general, you want to make sure that you have access to all of the fight pits. So you can see here in Cirith, Ungol, I do not. So the first thing that I'm going to do is unlock the other two fight pits, and you do that by sending in one of your followers and winning.
In my bark, I'll bite your head off. Another victim. I'll break your life.
So we'll want to look for warriors next.
Fight for Sauron, and I will gladly dedicate your death to him.
Another globe for slaughter.
It's a cannibal.
Go, outsider! Ready to explode?
Last but not least, champions.
Now you face a true follower of the Dark Flame.
Another maggot. Perfect.
So for the last siege upgrade, I usually go with fire mines, and that ties in with the build that I'm running a bit, which I'll get into a little later in the episode. Now we have to make sure that we have level 16 orcs for the entire defense and for all of the bodyguards for the war chiefs. We want to make sure that they're level 60 as well. We can send them into the fight pit and level them up over time. That is the process, though, so what's better to do is to go into the market, use up a lot of that Mirian that we have up top there, and deploy orcs, because now when you buy the silver war chest, you'll get high level orc followers pretty close to level 60, and then you only need to send them into the fight pit once or twice in order to get level 60. I've just purchased a ton of chests, opened all of them, so I'll show you me opening the last one and then how to build your army out of the orcs that you get out of these chests. As you can see, I now have 57 followers in my garrison. Should be more than enough, hopefully. You'll be looking for orcs that have no weaknesses. This one has a fear of ghouls, so if any ghouls show up, then he'll get dazed. You generally want to avoid weaknesses that will daze them, because that would make it easier in online quests or online conquests for invading enemy players to exploit those weaknesses and take out the captain. And so you'll try and find captains that have no weaknesses at all, or stealth is okay, because usually it's not worth the time in a conquest to use and exploit stealth mechanics. This guy is pretty good. If you see, he's immune to quite a bit of stuff. However, because of his fear of ghouls, I will probably destroy this guy. And the reason you destroy is so that you get the loot, which you can then deconstruct for Mirian, and then you can use that to buy more orcs. So I can do this repeatedly, buying silver war chests and destroying the orcs that I don't need until I get a full field of
This is an example of an ideal captain. He has no weaknesses. He is arrow-proof, poison-proof, immune to curse, and he has a curse weapon. Now this is the point where you want to be deploying war chiefs that you'll be using for the long term. So this is a good example of a captain that you want to keep around. He's got no weaknesses. And he's immune to poison, frost, and beasts. So he would be great with a... He currently has a fire weapon. We can replace that with a poison weapon. And he'll be good to go. So he was level 57. We want him to be level 60 before we promote him to War Chief. One way to do that is to use training orders. Which I don't currently have any of the training orders that will let me add levels to them directly, but there's two types of those, one that increases one level and then one that increases several levels. That's one way to do it. If you don't have any, then you can send him into the fight pits. Just send him into the maggot fight pit so that he doesn't have a chance of getting killed, and he'll gain one level or two levels each time he defeats the enemy captain, so we'll do that really quickly. And as you can see, he gained a level there, so we'll send him in two more times. The other thing I'll do really quickly is just give him the poison weapon so you can see that. And he now has poison weapon. And is immune to poison. He is now level 60, so we can move him up to become a permanent war chief. The first thing you'll want to do before deploying too many orcs is to clear out all of your low-level orcs so that you have empty spots in the field that you can deploy orcs to, and also to prevent you from having an orc become a war chief's bodyguard, and if he dies later because you need to kill him to deploy a level 60 orc, that can make the war chief become a weakened master or a shaken master, so you don't want to do that later on down the road. So what you'll want to do first, before any of the orcs can become bodyguards, is just have them do nemesis missions and kill each other so that you get rid of all the low-level ones. So we'll just create a pit fight like this. As you can see, I've killed off all of the orcs in the field, and I now have war chiefs for each of the posts. So I've made sure to give them all weapons of the type of damage that they're immune to. I've also given mounts to the captains that didn't have mounts previously, and made sure all of them have gangs. I've also given them epic traits if they didn't have them previously. And I made sure that my overlord has an arrow-proof trait, as well as having no weaknesses, and having something, some damage type he's immune to with a magic weapon. And I tend to still prefer marauders as my overlord so that I get the marauder keep. I think Warmonger might have somewhat better defenses, but this one seems to do well enough, and you find more gems and stuff when you're out of that. So So next I will deploy a bunch of level 60 orcs until I dominate the entire field. At that point, then I'll assign them as bodyguards to each of my warchiefs. I've deployed level 60 orcs into the entire field and organized them so that they have the same elemental resistance and weapon, so that I can have them become bodyguards to the respective warchief, and they'll be in generally the same area as the warchief should be. And the reason why I use that approach is so that I don't have any followers dying after I've made them a bodyguard to one of the warchiefs, because that can cause shake in a weak master. So he ends up being a shaken master, so we'll just swap him out for one of the other guys, which means he might betray us later. The way you can tell if he's going to or not is if he gets an air well after he moves. Set it up such that I've got four captains guarding each of the war chiefs with their respective elements, both weapons and immunities, and that's the way it'll end up. The only thing left to do is to finish up the missions, the Nemesis missions here for Crook the Wise and our Pratu, and once I finish those, then I should be able to assign these guys to their respective warchiefs and be ready for the Shadow War mission. Really quickly, once again, I'm just going to show the siege upgrade. So you'll want Defender Host, Iron Gates, Metal Walls, switching to Fiery Siege Beast because of the build that I'm running, Hellfire, Spiked Walls, and Fire Mines as well because of my build, which we're going to next. My favorite build for Gravewalker difficulty is to run four pieces of the War set and two pieces of the Outlaw set. Basically, for the war pieces, you'll want to have the armor, cloak, and if you can get it, the ring. The reason why you want those three pieces for the war set is that will allow you to regenerate health much more quickly while you're on fire, and it also causes you to explode when you're using four pieces of the set whenever you're on fire, which will spread fire around more, and then you'll be able to light yourself on fire again and continue to heal yourself. The Outlaw set is fantastic, but you really only need to use two pieces of it. All four, because what your followers do doesn't really matter. You'll want to have the two-piece set though, whatever items you can get, in order to get that 25% chance to inflict a status effect. Four gems. This will You'll still stay with the life gems. For all pieces other than the ring, and then for the ring it'll be the warrior gem. All perfect gems in each slot. This lets you have a lot more health. You'll be getting your health back both from the life tap from weapon attacks, as well as whenever you're on fire you'll be recovering health. So it just makes you a lot more durable. And with the explosions from the armor, you're also going to be causing enemies to not be able to attack you if they get close to you and you're exploding. So that helps a lot and makes it a lot easier to survive and control combat. Plus, the set looks really good. And I'm not going to go through all of the abilities. As you can see, I'm generally keeping the same setup with abilities as I had indicated early on in the videos. About the only thing that I'm doing differently now is... Eagle's Eyrie. So I like that because it lets me launch myself into the air and then turn around and stun everything if I need to. Using Talent Strike. Talent Strike is really good for just dazing everything around you so that you can get enough time to double charge your glaive. So that you can use Deadly Striker and hit repeatedly with your glaive. So those are the changes that I make at a high level. It makes you able to stand in combat a lot more effectively. You're still able to use your bow to good effect. In general, it's just a really good round build. Setting everything on fire so that hopefully I'll have a lot of fire to run around in, so I'll get my health back and be able to explode. We're now ready to do the Siege of Cirith, Ungol, our first Shadow Wars mission. We'll be using the same strategies as in previous sieges. Basically taking out the siege beasts first, looking for opportunities to isolate the captains and dominate them. We'll want to keep enemy captains on the field after we've dominated them to help the defense. And if there is a war beast, be sure to take it out quickly, otherwise it can knock down the walls pretty fast.
Thank you.
it's a fortress. I've seen ghoul mounds with better defenses.
Be sure to dominate and keep them on the field when it's possible.
You will join me! I will conquer for you! I have your back, my lord.
It's yours! What did I do to you?
Fighting! You and your boys don't stand a chance.
From the fire! Not good enough!
Get ready for it!
Kneel, boy! You will serve.
I am your servant. Your servant.
And as you can see, we're getting a little bit of the Altarial update benefits as well, so Talion is now speaking when he's dominating and such. The graphic interface for the inventory has changed a bit too.
First, we'll take your fort, then we'll turn you into Gordow.
That's all swine like you is good for. Why make it harder on yourself? Just give up and let me kill you.
As you can see, a fairly effective strategy overall. Got a little bit tight at the end there, but thankfully I didn't get executed. I think we'll stop this episode here. I hope you all enjoyed watching, and we'll see you in the next one for Blade of Galadriel. So I think we'll play through that next, and then I'll come back and finish up the rest of the Shadow War later. It's the same strategy all the way throughout to finish off Shadow War. It just takes a long time. So we'll do Galadriel next.